What is going on, everybody, and welcome back once again. My name is Jordan, also known as Jay Monster, and you are watching episode 2 of our Wood Elf campaign. Things are getting insane. We have intercepted this Beastman army at the point of the Oak of Ages. As you can see, it is quite sizable and would likely have overrun the garrison there. So we are forced to put ourselves between them and it, and we are going to have ourselves a nice little ambush battle here. A proper ambush battle this time, I guarantee it. I will see you guys on the battlefield. Alright guys, we are set up and ready. We have Durthu and his forces here on one spear, or on one spur rather. And the main thrust of our force, however, is going to be the tree cannon, these two units of Eternal Guard that you can see right here, under the command of our Spellsinger. And of course we have our archers up here on the heights, so that we can use them to maximum effect. We are going to use the slowdown function in this because I feel like that is needed in order to not take terrible, terrible casualties in this battle, because that's a lot of gores. Oh my god, is that a lot of gores. Actually, with that in mind, we are going to redeploy our Riders of Kurnus. We're going to need to use them in Hammered Anvil Strikes in combination with these two units of Eternal Guard here to break that huge blob of gores. So, here we are. I'm going to slow it down. There we go. And the ambush is sprung. We're going to move Durthu forward as quickly as possible. And we're going to take these guys and move them down here to confront their monstrous infantry, who are all located down here. Looks like they're going to be taking the bait, which is wonderful. We're going to move these guys into the back to deal with their Cygors, as well as Durthu himself. These units here of Eternal Guard are going to draw the gores up onto the hill, and that is where we are going to smash them to pieces. Just you wait. It'll totally work, I promise. Nothing could possibly go wrong. Aw, look at these guys. Look at these Chaos Spawn. Don't want to play games with them. Oh, taking it right on the chin there. That just wiped out that unit of Eternal Guard. That is a significant loss for those troops right there. What we need to do is give them a little bit of a boost, because they are going to need it. So right into the fray, right against them. We're going to stick them right here, get them braced. You as well, get them braced. See where Durthu is right now. His troops are coming down, coming into the rear. Yeah, we're going to need them. Let's deploy our Riders of Kurnus. Need to get them activated and get them down here so that they can run into the backs of these troops here. How are we doing? The Eternal Guard is apparently losing decisively to these very powerful monsters infantry. Oh no, Riders of Kurnus! Oh, they missed. Both times they missed. Take down these Cygors, silence their artillery. Our Glade Guard here a little farther back up the hill might be able to get some nice flank shots off on those troops there. We are managing to push back these Chaos Spawn here, which is good. Our fight against their monstrous infantry rather seems to be going reasonably well. What do we want to do here? Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Hopefully they run right into it. Kaboom! Doesn't do as much damage as I would like. How are we doing with our Riders of Kurnus here? Not so good. We need to reform, get them out of that combat, away from those archers, and into the backs of these gores here. Let's watch. Devastation. This is what the Wild Riders are very good at. To pull them back out of there. Looks like we've got some gore, or some centigores rather, on the flank. Direct our archers' fire onto them. How are we doing over here? Let's take down those big centigores. Reinforce our lines here. We need to get that Cygor. We need to get him now. How we doing on mana? We don't have a lot. We will have enough for an Earthblood pretty soon here, though, and that's a big deal.
Wild Riders!
Alright, so we've driven back the Centigors. Focus their attacks over here. The Centigors are on their way out. Time to get our Wild Riders of Kurnus back into this fight here. But it looks like they're just doing whatever they want, just screwing around with the Centigors. Okay, well, let's reform them. Oh, that was close. That was real close. Where's Durthu?
Eternal Guard!
Elgent Rustia!
to focus on these centaurs here, they can be a real problem if left unattended. Come on, Wild Riders. They're taking quite a beating, unfortunately. It's I keep losing micro on them. That is my bad. Okay, that one centaur now on its way out. See if we can't convince the other one that it's maybe a better idea to leave rather than stay. Looks like our Eternal Guard here are being overwhelmed. Our Riders of Kurnis are not being as quite as effective here as I would have hoped. We need to focus on those centaurs there. And we're going to move these guys a little bit farther down the hill so we can get some easy shots here into the sides of these beastmen. Oh, keep moving! Not too sure what to do with my Wild Riders right now. Maybe it's a good idea to go and take on these Ungor Raiders. Eternal Guard. Yeah, none of these guys are really fast enough to catch those guys. So we're going to bring our archers a little bit farther down here. Pop Earthblood down on these two. Give them a little bit of extra health. Very good. Very good. We've managed to see these Beastmen troops off in true Wood Elven fashion with a little bit of maneuvering, but mostly a good old-fashioned ambush. So I'm going to run these guys down, and I will see you guys back on the campaign map. And with that, the Oak of Ages has once again been successfully defended, although our forces are quite reduced as a result of that. Excuse me.
Strong in the face of adversity. Make sure it remains so, my lord.
See, I wish before making these decisions I had an opportunity to look at kind of how my Chaos Corruption is doing. Let's leave it be for now. I don't really want to spend the money. Money is very precious to me. Non-renewable resource when you're Argobalon. Let's increase their armor just a little bit farther. You have yet more. That's good. Buff the weapon strength just a little bit. So now our armies are going to start to be able to be absolute monsters, total meat grinders. Yep, we're going to have to go and finish them off, absolutely. So I will see you guys on the battlefield once again. Alright, so before actually going... make sure our... What are you doing out here? You can hide up here, just in case they try to sally forward. We have someone to harass them. But what we're going to do here before we even get started is a little bit of field triage here, because unfortunately our spear companies are having not a very good time. Many of them are very low health here, so we're actually going to pop down some healing buffs onto them, give them a chance to regenerate some of their health. Eternal God. Which apparently isn't doing anything, because that's where their health is capped. Ugh! So much for my clever plan. Well, alrighty then. Well, we are just going to have to sally forth and deal with our enemies the old-fashioned way. So we're going to stick our Eternal Guard in front here. We have a few options. No, we can't unfortunately go around this hill to avoid that artillery, so we are going to have to take them head on, go right into the teeth of their artillery units. That's alright. It's not going to be quite so easy as it was the last time. But we're going to send Durthu in first, have him run. Yeah. Maybe he can, maybe Durthu can draw some of the fire of the artillery units. If not, no big deal. We are going to leave these guys back here in reserve though, because if they get hit by one or two artillery volleys, they're going to fall apart. Oh no, here it comes. Yeah, if we can keep moving as quickly as possible, our Eternal Guard should be okay. That's another miss, another near miss by those Beastmen Cygors. Are they moving them back just a little bit? Good. Reclaim.
Deep wood infantry. Tire high.
Alright. Just gotta keep moving.
Ready to fire. Wild Riders.
Oh. That one's gonna hurt. That was unfortunate.
Way Watchers!
It is done! Forever loyal! Go! Eternal Guard!
Oh, they managed to hit our Wild Riders. That's not a bad thing, though. Not necessarily.
Orders! Orders! Ever ready! Aye! Ever ready!
There we go. Use that to keep our units up here. We're going to give the unit in range of their general a little bit of extra armor, because they're going to need it. Give some missile damage to our troops there. Where are our Wild Riders? What are you doing with yourselves? Oh man, they killed so many of them. I'm going to get them in the back there. Get these guys up. We need to take some shots at these Cygors and drive them back. They have only a little bit of health, so we should be able to maul them with some arrows if we can get some good, accurate volleys in there. I don't know where Durthu is, but he's a little bit too slow. Durthu needs to deal with their commander. Yeah, I'm gonna bring these guys around, run down this Cygor right here, finish the job. Die! Oh man, what does it take to kill you? Just die already! Alright, I will see you guys back on the campaign map. There we go. That is the end of that Beastman army. We didn't take too many losses, about 45. I mean, it could definitely have gone worse for us. We are going to move into Threlok so that we are in kind of the middle of our territory, so that we don't have too far to go to support either of our holdings. Let's see. What do we have here that can be useful? That'll get us some war dancers. I kind of want to turn this into a bit of a breadbasket, if possible. Oh good, you've leveled up again. How wonderful. That will help you move around on the battlefield, and that will help you even more to accomplish that. Alright. That's going to be really useful. See, now you start to get all these lord buffs and all these technology buffs. That's when your Wood Elven armies really start to shine. Please don't declare war on me. Aw, oh, defensive alliance. You know what? You're a small territory who shares a border with another small territory. I'm not too worried about you causing a cascading sequence of alliances that will pull us into a World War III. Don't offer me a defensive alliance. Trade agreement works for me. Wow, look at that. Look at our economy starting to take off. I feel comfortable. Alright. Well, let's upgrade that to the hollow. That'll be really useful for economy as well as defense. The wood elves are camping out, squatting on my property. Let's see if they have any unfortunate intentions. It doesn't look like it, though.
Stands before me.
What about a trade agreement? Oh, they accepted it. How wonderful. How wonderful. Let's see here. Who don't we have an agreement with? Oh, nice. We can, we have war coordination targets available to us now. That's going to be really useful once the big Beastmen invasion starts. Tread carefully. Kavarok. Do I have a trade with you? Yeah, I do. Cannot trade with Kavarok just yet. Now, I don't have the connecting territories in order to open a trade route. Well, that's going to do for that turn. Let's pass it on. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Oh, a trade agreement. How wonderful. Look at our economy just going through the roof. You want to be friends? Oh wow, look at this. And they're gonna pay us for it too. Everyone wants to be our best friend. This has never happened in this campaign before, I swear. Normally it's a lot harder. I think we kind of lucked out with jumping that beastman army as they came into the northern borders of Athalorn. If you can prove yourself a defender of the forest, then everyone tends to like you quite a lot. Growth, some extra income. Look at that income. That is incredible. We won't be able to get that for a while. Well, let's get ourselves another unit of Eternal Guard. They're just generally useful and pretty good against a lot of the units that the Beastmen have to bear. One of the things I've noticed that I'm a little bit disappointed about is that the Beastmen don't seem to use Minotaurs at all. And I'm not sure why that is. Warrior send off leadership. Yeah, let's do that. Good, we're gonna get another construction slot there, and then we can build one of the little archery areas so that we can just flit between the two borders and recruit whatever it is that we need. Oops, that's what I want. Man, look at the income from that, from Vol's Anvil. Not quite as good as Threlok just yet, but... Defensive Alliance. Let's take a look at their relations with all of their neighbors. That's fine. Their relations are pretty good. We don't seem to be at too much of a risk right there, but we're going to have to limit it to just those couple defensive alliances. Plus, that's really useful because it will give us possible military access so that I can stop kind of skirmishing on the borders here and actually fall back to choke points around the Oak of Ages. You know, I do have an extra. Maybe we'll just yeah, this is probably a better idea. Actually, no, it's not. We're going to build an Azrai Forge there. We're going to wait for that to be done, then we're going to build our Bowman area there so that we have kind of an industrial military heartlands. And I think that that'll probably be the best idea. And then down here we can just turn this into a little bit more of a breadbasket as we get an opportunity to do so. Next turn, for example. Yeah, those beastmen are just kind of walking around, just doing their own thing. Another trade agreement. Things are going really well. This is where stuff starts to cascade. I want to deal with the extra chaos corruption. What's that dragon mage gem do? 5 resistance. You know, that would be really useful for Durthu because he's weak to fire attacks, and if we ever get into a fight with our Wood Elven brothers, a lot of their magical arrows tend to have both magic and fire attacks attached to them. So you know what, we are actually going to take the Chaos Corruption. Just this once, though. It's not so bad. Okay. Could increase that, but I would much rather get this underway. That's only 1,500. Buff up our army just a little bit more, increase their defensive offensive capabilities rather. And let's march them. Okay, we do have that now, so we can start disbanding a few of these units here and creating something new. Sorry, I kind of lost my train of thought there. I was thinking about too many things at once. Creating some of our Eternal Guard shield. Yeah, that'll do. That's cool. We're gonna ignore them. Nothing we can do there for now, Adiana. That's really useful. Plus 20% armor for all our Elven troops. By the time we have to fight a serious enemy, we're going to be more than prepared. Military access. Oh, thank God, this is what we needed. They don't usually give this out in the diplomacy screen either. Military access, sure. So now we have some room to maneuver. We're not just necessarily relegated to this one little corridor right here. Which kind of looks a little bit like a penis. Just sharing that with you guys. Alright. What can we build over here? Oh, that wants to be upgraded. Well, we're not going to do that right now. You know, I think three Eternal Gods' Shield is kind of okay. It's really expensive to continue making them. No, we'll go for it. And then we'll work on getting some more archers in the next turn. Yeah, there's a lot of waiting that can take place in the Wood Elf campaign. A lot of, looks like the wait may be over, however.
Alright.
Time to move ourselves northward and take on our enemies in the field. Deepwood Scouts. Swift Shiver Shards are actually very good. What they do is give you two shots instead of one, effectively increasing their damage and their ammo by two in a single bound. They do suffer a bit on range, but 150, that's not so bad. Yeah, the Deepwood Scouts generally have a little bit of a shorter range. But they're not as cost effective as the Glade Guard, so we're not going to focus on them too much. We don't have a Bowyer Workshop, so we'll have to get some Hagbane tips. It's going to be a little bit expensive, it's going to dip into our surplus, but that's alright. I see they're going to pillage some other lands. Well, we want to, let's say they've destroyed Brunaire. Well, that'll be an opportunity for expansion up there a little bit later, but right now we want to deal with the imminent threat that is the Beastmen. What do I need? I have insufficient funds. Well, I would like to upgrade this a little bit more and fill out the rest of my army with three units of tree men, or two units of tree men and some wild riders, whatever happens to come first, but I don't think we'll be getting the horse buildings that we need for that anytime soon. Cover all buildings, sacrifice. Let's do income right now. I can hit them. I have a straight shot. We need to get a treaty concluded with these guys right here. So let's go ahead and do that.
You may keep your lying tongue.
I really need military access, guys. I can get those rid of those beastmen for you. Come on. Alright, well, we'll just have to try and cut them off if we can. If they attacked the city, we might have some trouble, but I think that the garrison there. Wildwood Rangers, Treekin, we'll get another unit of Wildwood Rangers as a general unit. Glade Guard, lots of Eternal Guard, Glade Riders, and a Tree Man. You know, we might be able to hold that in the event that they actually attack us. In a straight fight, anyway, we might be able to do okay. So we're gonna chance it. We're gonna roll the dice here. Come on, step over that line. Thank you! Defensive Alliance. I mean, sure, if it keeps them off our back for longer, then that would be wonderful. I don't expect me to honor that, though. I'm not going to fight for the Bretonians against another Wood Elf faction, for example. Let's see if we can't. Yeah, if we can put ourselves in good position for an ambush. That does put us just outside the range of reinforcements for Threlok, but again, they've got a pretty good garrison, so I think that they'll be able to hold out. in the events of any Beastman aggression. What do we have over here? This is a regional capital, so it might be worth it to try and open up our tech tree a little bit farther and get ourselves some Glade Riders and some Wild Riders of Kurnus. So maybe that's what we're going to do. We'll use this for like our Elven infantry. Up there is where we're going to get our tree men from, and down here will be our zone of recruitment for our horses. Seems like a reasonable thing to do. Ah, ambush failed. They don't have any Cygors. They do have a reasonable amount of gores and bestigores, with great weapons no less, so they do actually pose a threat even to our shielded Eternal Guard. But obviously we're going to have to fight it, so I will see you guys on the battlefield. Set up, ready to go. Our forces are moving quickly into position. Durthu leading the way, our Spellsinger getting herself into the middle of where our armies are going to be deployed. We've got two wings here. I want to try and draw them into the middle here. And hit, if I can, I want to draw all of their infantry into the middle here where these archers are, and then we can envelop them and completely surround and crush them. One of the things that we have going for us is that they do not have any Cygors. They do, however, have quite a lot of these Chaos Spawn, which is going to be a bit of a difficult time for us. They also have a unit of Bestigors in here as well, who are extremely potent, armor-piercing, and very difficult for our Eternal Guard to deal with. So we're going to have to try and take some of the load off of them by finding out where those Bestigors are going to be deployed, and then using our Wild Riders of Kurnus, who are hidden in the forest here, to deal with them. And naturally, in reserve, we have our tree men here to prevent any gaps in our line, because they're very good at holding a position as long as you give them a little bit of support. Don't let them get surrounded and have their morale broken, and heal them, etc., etc., etc. So let's see if we can't kick the fight off here. Bit of a bang.
Wild Riders.
What we're actually gonna do? Move our front line just a little bit forward, so that our what are these guys? They're way watchers, so that our way watchers have a place to fall back to in the event that they charge forward with their centaurs. Oh yeah, here we go. That's all it takes to bait the AI. Just a few light casualties. The neat thing about these archers, and why I would love to take them, but I feel that they're a little bit overpriced, is because they can do this. Skirmish while moving. Very good at drawing your enemy into traps. It looks like they are attempting a little bit of a flanking movement here with a lot of their centigores and some of their gores and their chaos spawn. So we're going to shift these archers onto that side. Since there's less of a danger from centigores and monstrous infinity on our left flank, we're going to shift Durthu to the other side so that he can support his tree men brothers, or his tree kin brothers, I should say. Oh yeah, look at that. Centigores and great weapons, we're going to try and focus them down. Did a good job there softening up their front lines. Give our spearmen a bit of a break. Actually, we're gonna set these guys up this way, because there is a big flanking movement here that we are gonna need to deal with. Our Glade Guard should be able to hold and do their jobs. Well, that's a little bit weird. Okay, we've managed to drive those Centigors back so we can reposition ourselves here. Let's start to surround their lines. They are kind of taking the bait and funneling into here, which is good. How are we doing in the center there? Not so good. Oh, that's unfortunate. Yeah, it's a little bit of an audio issue that I've been having. Don't worry, I'm in the process of investigating and figuring that out. There's quite a lot that they have to deal with there. Well, we're gonna need to get Durthu in there immediately. Give these guys a little bit of a buff. We'll use that once Durthu's locked in melee combat. How are we doing over here? Earthblood's gonna be off cooldown pretty quickly. We're gonna need to use that to keep our line here alive, because otherwise these chaos spawn and gores and such are going to chew right through them. Oh no, it takes way longer than I thought it did. Alright, Durthu, do your thing, bud. Kaboom! It's a huge morale shock for those guys.
Uh-oh.
Set up our firing line there.
As you said.
Whoop.
Bowman, ready.
We have a big blob there that's just asking for it. These guys are gonna need it to keep them in the fight for longer. Try and minimize our casualties. Let's watch Durthu do work. Oh, these beastmen don't have a chance. These three men here are more than capable of taking a hit and being able to stand up to these monsters in three. So we are going to pop a heal on them ASAP, because I don't want to lose them at all. Yeah, they are taking some, they are having a little bit of difficulty here, trapped in a fight against these centaurs. I think some of them actually had great weapons, which is quite good for penetrating their very thick, gnarly hides.
End them! Yes! Troops!
Looks like their general here barely taking any damage, but he's getting ready to run too. Another general rout for this Beastman army. How you doing over here? Pop that down on our tree, man.
Our bows are yours! It will be done!
Alright, we're gonna need to put an end to these chaos spawn here. I've had just about enough of their shenanigans. Hopefully this hits them where I need it to hit them. Yeah, I think we managed to spare our elves most of the brunt of that. That's gonna kill our Eternal Guards, and we're gonna stop that immediately. Looks like another general rout here. We actually never even used our wild guard of, or wild riders of Kurnus. We didn't really need to. They kind of came to us and got slaughtered a little bit, which I'm more than happy about, because every time we seem to bring our wild riders of Kurnus out, they take quite a beating. So that's it for that. I will see you guys back on the campaign map. Another crushing victory here against the Beastmen, which is a little bit surprising, but we did manage to... has been attacked. See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. We have a trade agreement with both of these people, but we need the one with the Wood Elves more, and luckily it does actually give us a little bit more money. So we're going to enter the war on the side of the ally, and maybe we'll actually have an opportunity here, now that the Beastmen have been pushed back, to expand our territory just a little bit. Let's move up to about here. We'll just go all the way. That's fine. I'm not quite ready to make another army yet. So we don't really need to buy the upgrade for the Spellsinger Palace, because we're not going to see any benefit from that for a while. I don't see any point in doing that either. This is a really powerful spell. Let's look at that. It's a fancy power reserve. Sure. We'll be able to get some Earthmen on our, or our Treekin, rather, on our next turn, which is kind of nice. Athelwith, they're much farther north, and that's more of a Wood Elf problem. We don't really have any trade relations with them, but you see what I mean? This is how alliances can pull you into fights that you really don't want to be in. Yeah, we'll move up to there. Let's pop ourselves down into replenishment stance, and that should be enough to round off our forces for now while keeping our economy in an okay place. Alright, let's move on. That seems more of a Wood Elf problem. I really can't do anything from where I am. Unhappy populace and Threlok. What do you guys have to be unhappy about? Ward answers Azurai. That's actually a good thing to work up to. But my forces as they are... I'm quite satisfied with them. Maybe it's better to invest in our economy. I don't know, what can we build over here? That would give us... No, we're just going to invest in our economy for now. That's probably the smartest thing to do. I wish I could figure out where the hell they went to. Are we at war with these guys now as well? No. Pop ourselves down right there. And trading stance. Lovely. Global recruitment capacity. Enemy siege holdout time, -4. You know what? We might end up in a siege over here, yeah.
Not possible.
I don't know if we could take on their entire army plus their garrison, but we might be able to draw them out if we raid them a lot. Looks like they were pushed back. Aquitaine. Paravon. Oh, Paravon. Oh, they're being attacked. How good are my relations with Paravon? Not great, and they have an aversion. You know, I really don't care about Paravon. You're
protect
on your own.
Protect the Oak of Ages, my lord. Should it fall, the sacred forest will surely wilt away with it.
I don't see him getting a whole lot of use out of that. And that's only within his, like, kind of sphere of influence. It does open up this tech tree here, so that's kind of nice. Let's give them a little bit more weapon strength. It looks like we've done exactly what we wanted to do. But, let's see, what kind of army do they have there? Let's take a look at what kind of garrison we'd be facing. I got a couple of tree men. I'd much rather starve that army out and fight these guys. So what we're going to do, I think... Oh, it takes so much movement points to cross that river. What's the other way back?
Frasina.
Puts us just outside range. I don't know, let's see what happens. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Given that Threlok is an open revolt at this point. Well, not open revolt, but they're quite unhappy. Now let's move them up here, and then we'll move just onto their border, try and entice them to come and say hello, and then we'll switch ourselves into raiding stance in the next turn. Yeah, I can't really research any technology right now. Audience of Elves. Owner of -4. Give me a lot more money, but I'm a little bit concerned about my public order right now. Start with that. I guess we should have done that last turn. Oh well. There's really only one way for them to get across here, so let's stick ourselves down in ambush stance. They might not know that we're there. Increase our economy just that much more.
Certainly not.
Quick look. Deteriorating. That's
this
not good.
This is Athaloran, home of the.
They don't like that. We need to start working on our amber reserves as well. Yeah, I want to be able to upgrade the Oak of Ages soon, because then we can actually, once you get to the second level of the Oak of Ages is when you can start confederating with other elven factions, and just generally I think your relations, I guess, increase with them. Oh good, we've driven them from their hiding spot. It's time to destroy them completely. I have a lot of glaive guard. Have a lot of war dancers who are all very lightly armored. We're gonna stick our tree men on the front line to deal with all of that, backed up by our eternal guard with shields. Should be good. I will see you guys on the battlefield. Right, here we go. We have everybody in position. We've got our tree men here in the front. We have kind of like a staggered line formation, I guess. We've got our tree men in the front here to be backed up by our eternal guard. These guys are going to soak up a lot of the incoming missile fire. Of course, we have our Glade Guard as well to support them. We have a bit of an oblique formation here, in that we've double stacked our Eternal Guard on this side, and that's because I want them to push forward hard here, and they're going to be getting buffed by Durthu, so that we can crush them on the flank when it comes to the melee engagement, and then we can start to roll up their lines. Although, that's kind of how I'm hoping it's going to turn out. The War Dancers aren't actually very potent in melee, so it may not turn out that way at all. But that is more or less our strategy. We also have some options up here, and then we have some hidden units. So we are going to move our butts forward. Yeah, we're gonna move up there.
As you say.
Secretly, I was kind of hoping that we'd be able to draw them into position, or out of position rather. And into a trap, but I think what we're gonna do, I'm just gonna move these guys forward and see if we can't pull them forward right now.
Aim, release.
Let's take some shots at those glade guards, see how well we do. I'm gonna be shooting through the trees here, so we might not do as well as I'd like to. Can I just say that I'm really excited about the mechanics that we introduced with these guys? Because I know absolutely that we are going to see them with the Shadow Warriors when the High Elves come out. Holy hell! Look at that! Look at that wave of arrows. Whoa, that's really weird. Aw, one sec, guys. Aha, so the temporary solution to that unfortunate issue that is apparently quite common. We're just gonna have to run it in slow motion, so you get to enjoy the battle a lot more. So I don't think that's so bad. So we are actually rushing our forces forward here. The tree men aren't taking nearly as much of the beating that I would like them to, but they are gonna get stuck in with our enemies here. They are rushing everyone forward. All these war dancers. We're gonna support them with our eternal guard here. Durthu into the fight as well. There's quite a lot of war dancers over on this end. We will be able to very quickly overwhelm these war dancers, though, I believe. Which is going to let us start to roll up those lines, and we can actually move these guys forward here a little bit to try and support Durthu's thrust as he moves in. But it turns out that our tree men are actually having a little bit more trouble than I would like them to. So we're gonna pop down a nice heal on them. Pop an earth blood right next to them so that everyone can benefit. Oh, there we go. This apparently takes a little bit longer to cast because it is a very potent spell. It also increases their physical resistance. Which, in hindsight, maybe would have been a better idea to use over here, because these guys are fighting Wildwood Rangers, who specialize in taking down monsters such as Artrekian, as they are from the Wildwood, and that's where the crazy dryads and the crazy murderous treekin tend to live, so they definitely specialize in it's definitely a good fight for them, but we have all of our troops here being backed up by very powerful units of Eternal Guards here, so let's take a quick look. Oh yeah, that doesn't look so bad. Running reasonably well here. I don't want to use his super nuke ability just yet. See if we can't focus down some of these Glade Guard. We seem to be having issues with them. Turn the slow back on before things get too crazy. Don't worry, I will fix that for the next episode. I will make sure that things are working 100%. Unfortunately, that's an issue that only seems to come up in much larger battles. But I guarantee you it has nothing to do with my processor or my computer, or very little to do with it, because even people with amazing computers seem to be having this issue. So the good news is that it's not hardware and that it is fixable. There's not really a lot of room to try and sneak our Wild Riders into the fight here. Maybe we could use them to try and take down some of these Wildwood Rangers, although I think they have anti-large capabilities, so maybe that's not the best fight. Let's take a quick look. Yeah, they do. I was just talking about this. Yeah, Hagbane tips maybe aren't the best using these Glade Guard, but their constant damage is managing to do a little bit of a number on their health here. So it looks like we're gonna have a breakthrough right here. Durthu is just doing work. He is essentially the forested avatar of Cain. I mean, look at that. Look at that sword. Look at the arrows flying back and forth here. In slow motion, too. This is just a beautiful thing to see. How are we doing in the middle? Looks like our wood... our treekin here having a bit of an issue. Trying to break through all these war dancers. There is quite a lot of them. Let's give them a little bit more of a boost. Over here, we are breaking them, so we are my oblique strategy here is working quite nicely. We're going to be able to commit some forces here to rounding up these troops and surrounding them and completely destroying them. And in the meantime, we can keep doing a number on the ranged units, and we can push some of our victorious units here forward in order to break up this line and disrupt their fire. Durthu, in particular, is a great candidate for that. Let's see. No, we won't do that. I don't have any heals coming up here. That's kind of unfortunate. Maybe we will give these troops here a bit of a boost with one of Durthu's buffs. Bam! There we go! Disrupt these guys. It's time to turn off our archer's fire. Yeah, we've got a lot of these troops here are just able to move forward. Let's start doing that, try and move some of our treekin into the fray here. Durthu is just kind of staring at these guys. He just obliterated them with his lamentation of despair. So let's turn this back on to full speed here. Yeah, see, look at this. Durthu is pissed. Let's enjoy this. Whoop. Little wood elf lord. Feel the wrath of the eldest of the forest. Oh man, look at that damage. That's brutal. We're pushing them back here. Very, very decisive fight. Unfortunately, their lightly armored war dancers make great support infantry, but not the best line infantry. It's unfortunately going to be the end of them. I wonder what our Wild Riders and Kurnus are doing. They just kind of stood over here. I keep forgetting to micro them. Honestly, they're not an integral part of my army. It really reposes mostly on my ability to win the ranged battle and keep my lines happy and healthy and not completely annihilated, which we'll be able to do here with some treekin and this Lord of Life caster. So, let's see here. No, they're gonna get out of here before we can run them down. Well, I will see you guys back on the campaign map. A decisive victory. We'll actually be able to replenish some of our troops here because we did fight another Wood Elf faction. So we're gonna take on some prisoners. Let's see here.
Ill considered.
Got a couple options here. Oh, that's a Waystone. That's really cool. These Waystones are very important because they draw elven souls into them so they don't get consumed by Slaanesh. They're pretty much the same thing as the Infinity Stones in the Warhammer 40k universe. They want to kill them, or they want to go directly for their heartland. You know, we're gonna deal with this threat behind us first, before anything else happens. So I'm just going to, you guys want to see this battle? You probably want to see this battle. Alright, fine, I'll see you on the battlefield. Alrighty then, so we had a bit of a crash, unfortunately. So I had to fight the battle you guys just saw previous to this again, and we didn't quite do as well. So unfortunately our forces are a little bit more diminished than I would have liked them to be, and that they would have otherwise been. But the traitorous Wood Elven factions also did not fare nearly as well. So they actually have less troops in this battle as well, so I suppose it kind of works out. Alright. Two.
Hold formation.
There we are.
Way watchers.
Let's see. Where'd a sneaky place for you guys to hide be? Let's put them here, and then if they have any incoming fire, we can kind of play the corners with that little tree
wild
right there.
Riders.
And we'll do the same with our Wild Riders of Kurnus as well. Stick them right behind there. We are actually getting some reinforcements in this battle as well. So we're just going to go ahead and start deployment. But first, we need to figure out where our enemy is. On the far side of that hill. Look at this. I feel bad for them.
Straight away.
Put them up there. You in the center. You rushing for the front. And of course, we have some allies coming onto the battlefield over here on the flank directly behind them. And this is a garrison, so I actually have zero compunctions throwing their lives away because they will just regenerate very quickly.
Way watchers.
So we're going to stick these guys up here on this hill. I'm going to bring our Wild Raiders around that far side of the tree and swoop around and hit these guys in the rear. Let's take a look at this pitiful force here arrayed against us. The last stand of Arda of the Partel Vale. Very, very proud looking forces that unfortunately won't be with us very much longer. Let's see what we got here. Some Glade Riders. Support that thrust with our Glade Guard. Got two units of Treekin over here as well. Move our tree men forward. Our Eternal Guard into position to help our archers here if they need it. Oop, don't want you to withdraw. Let's take a moment and enjoy this. And move our Deepwood Scouts forward as well. Everyone rush forward in just one big, massive bum rush. There we go. Push you forward. I don't know where Durthu is. Probably lost micro on him somewhere. Oh, there he is. He's over on the hill. I want him to take down their lord himself, but I don't think he's going to have the opportunity, unfortunately. These guys run right towards their glaive infantry. And I guess we'll have our tree man walk forward as well. Oh, this is not gonna go well for you guys. Looks like their lord here is getting caught in the retreat. Beautiful. That's what I love to see. Plop that down, this way everyone gets a nice heal. Put the extra one onto our Treekin. You guys can all shoot these poor unfortunate souls right here. to get rid of these war dancers. Time to put an end to this Amazon army. Oh yes! Durthu took her down after all! Oh, that makes me so happy. Yes! A roar of victory, and then we win the battle. I hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you on the campaign map. I have to say, Durthu raising his hand to the sky in defiant victory. Just like that. Just like that. That's probably one of the coolest moments I think I've had in a Warhammer campaign. You are nothing to me now. Well, we're gonna camp here for the time being, and then we're going to move over to the Glade of Eternal Moonlight and expand our holdings. Thus, always, to people who stand in our way. I wouldn't even call them traitors, honestly. We kind of just got dragged into a war against them, and it's just going very badly for them. Let's do that. So far, so good. Cromlech of Kedai. It looks like this faction here has been completely destroyed, so that does leave the rest of the province open to us. So after we deal with them, we'll try and get down there before somebody else stakes claim into that fertile, juicy piece of land. We really do need the amber at this point. We need to start saving up for the first Oak of Ages transformation. But first, let's give Durthu a bit of love. That's really useful. Speed is always fun. Let's pass the turn. I hope they don't attack the Oak of Ages. Surely they're not that foolish. The Azurai have long had a patchy relationship with the denizens of the forest. Whilst often the two peoples get along harmoniously, there has been issues lately. Malevolent dryads, imagine that, have taken to kidnapping elven children for fun. When brought to justice, they remain unrepentant. It's their forest, they say, to burn them would anger the forest, but surely they must be made to pay for their crimes. Send them to the Wildwood, and they can be killed by us at a later
Not
date.
Possible.
We get farther with this? No. We will get directly into their territory, which is what I like. So they're gonna get cut off from their reinforcements here at the Glade of Eternal Moonlight, and then we are going to burn it to the ground. No, just kidding, we're gonna take it over, but yeah. Something I haven't taken a look at recently is the... Oh, you wanna fight Vol's Anvil, do ya? Argawan is apparently raiding us. That is a little bit unfortunate. Nothing I can do about it right now, and we do have a solid garrison here, so I'm not super worried about them being able to take it with that token force. That is a little bit worrisome. That is Morgur himself! Basically, the devil has come to our doorstep. First things first, though. We are going to encircle and besiege them. Let's see, how many turns? Only two remaining before they run out of supplies, so we will be able to burn them down in a few turns. But that will have to be a battle that you guys see another time, as we have come to the end of episode 2. I hope you guys have been enjoying the series so far. For me, it has been a lot of fun, very action-packed. But from the look of things, from the looks of that Beastmen army up there in the north, it's only going to get better. So, yeah, I'll see you guys later, and as always, take care, everybody. Bye-bye!